Top of the morning to you. Welcome aboard to another fabulous morning of Martini Mornings here only on moodfoodradio.com. And with me this morning, I have the founders and ambassador of a fantastic new service, Silver Memories. Now, Silver Memories is being piped into our aged care facilities to the delight of so many people. So I can't wait to have a chat today with the amazing Mirusia and Gary of Silver Memories. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Nice Hello. To be here.
Now, you are based in wonderful Brisbane, but you are sending out the most wonderful nostalgic music all over Australia.
Yes, we are. And it's being sent out via satellite. So anywhere in Australia, the signal is perfect. The Optus fast satellite covers the whole country. And then it gets channeled through to the TV sets of residents in aged care into their rooms. So it's really accessible.
Yeah, very accessible, yes. And our seniors now are getting more tech savvy. And we know that the clinical studies of actually having music of their era as well is so wonderful for their mental health as well as other medical conditions.
You're absolutely correct. It's based on reminiscence therapy, and there's an enormous amount of research into reminiscence therapy. But interestingly, the most powerful reminiscence tool is music. And it's usually the music of your youth. Your musical tastes tend to be established in your late teens or mid-20s. And that's what you move forward through in your life that brings back those memories. So we then have programmed Silver Memories for people who are 80 years old and over. So the music of their youth is the music of the 1930s, 1940s, 1950s, through to the 1960s, and going a little bit into the early 1970s for sort of slightly younger.
What people. A fabulous range of music, Gary. And I mean, really, that music is having a resurgence as well. It's been really, but by some of the movies that have come out recently, has really put forth this music again. So really, I can imagine it's not just for our seniors, it's for all of the carers, the nursing staff around them would be enjoying all of this as well.
You're absolutely correct. We get so much feedback that the residents, armed with this knowledge about the music, are able to engage in really meaningful discussions and conversations with the younger staff. The younger staff will say, "Oh, that's lovely. Who's that?" And I'll say, "Oh, that's Bing Crosby."
Yeah.
And they'll tell them all about Bing or Frank Sinatra or Doris Day, Judy Garland. So the residents then have the power of that knowledge, and it really lifts their spirits and their sense of self-worth and well-being. It's a wonderful tool on many levels.
So many levels. And how wonderful to have Mirusia involved with this whole project. Mirusia, we know you the world over as Andre Rieu's star soprano. You were singing amazing songs that are resonant within so many households for really a decade until COVID came along and closed its doors on so many live performances. But you have really enabled a renaissance of this music, of your own music, in this COVID pandemic lockdown.
Yes, I mean, this whole thing worldwide, the pandemic has just been, it's been awful for everyone. But I think The people that are affected by it the most are the elderly, the people in aged care, the people who are really suffering from loneliness.
Yes.
And then add to that the fact that the arts has been so impacted. I mean, concert tours can't go ahead, things that we had planned in the pipeline, just all postponed, constantly postponed, maybe even cancelled. It's such a depressing time for us in the arts as well, where we've kind of seen no end in sight. But combine the two together and make something good out of it. Think of happy thoughts. Think of something positive that you could come out of it. Well, you've got arts and you've got aged care. combine the two and everyone's happy again, because I'm able to sing again, I'm able to perform. I'm so grateful that Gary approached me. He messaged me on LinkedIn. He said, hey, would you be interested in coming on board as ambassador of Silver Memories? And I was totally, totally blown out of the water. At that point, I was thinking, what am I going to do? What am I doing here? I can't tour. My tours in New South Wales and Victoria had just been postponed again. For the third, sometimes even fourth time. Yeah. And when Gary came to me with that, I thought, this is a perfect solution for everyone. Yeah. And I did my research and I've looked into Silver Memories and the things that we are doing. And it is incredible, the power that music has. And I've always known that. I've always known that there is a power that music has. But to be able to bring it in this way, it's something very, very special. And yeah, so we've combined forces with the arts and aged care. And now look at us. We're creating new memories.
Yes, yes. But this isn't a far jump for you, Mirusia. I mean, you have been on the stages worldwide, bringing your beautiful talent, your music to so many people. But you actually started not too far from our seniors as a small child. Tell us about that experience.
That's right. Well, my mum has always worked in aged care. She's a diversional therapist by trade, and she would bring me along to the retirement villages where she was working at, and I would sing there. So I would trial new music. I would see, you know, how does this song fly? Do the people like it? And it was a lovely way for me to also experience the power of music back then. Mm. At that time, when you're growing up, you don't really realize what you're doing. You don't really know what it is that you're doing. By singing a song, I was more focused on the performance and getting it right. I wasn't so much focused on what it was doing to others until I realized when I went into the high care ward where my mum was working, and people were laying, maybe, you know, at having their last moments, mm-hmm. I was coming in and singing them songs, and their eyes would come to life and they would reach out to me, mm-hmm. and say, thank you, you just brought back so many memories. Mm-hmm. And I remember it was the first time that I had been affected by what I was doing, and I realized, yes, this is a powerful tool. Music is a powerful tool. And then I ended up going to the Conservatorium of Music. I ended up touring the world with Andre Rieu. And along that time, and in that time, I've never forgotten that. I've never forgotten that power that music has. And I've done many performances for aged care around the world.
Yes.
And special performances where we've been able to bring even people who are in beds, that could come to these theatres with special access. I mean, this was so incredible to be able to give that experience. But now to be able to sort of come full circle back in Brisbane, where I was growing up, to come full circle and to be able to now travel to these wonderful retirement villages, aged care centres, they're actually just so wonderful. And the feedback is beautiful, but just to be able to bring that happiness, that's what we're doing it for. We're doing it for to bring back memories, to bring back happiness and to engage. That's so special.
Absolutely. And as well, another layer of that, Gary and Mirusia, is that we are, you know, in lockdown and we're quite fatigued, we're exhausted, it's quite confusing. And the social isolation that brings along, especially to our older generation, is quite frightening. So to have this as a comfort is just so reassuring to people like me. In my home, I can't go and visit friends and family in aged care facilities in their villages, but at least I know that they are they're able to access such wonderful memories, nostalgia, being able to chit chat about this. So thank you for providing such a wonderful platform and forum for that.
Yes, that's the whole idea, really, and that's why we considered how to best, you know, use the power of music. And with people of a certain age, radio was a companion.
Yes.
For them. And that's why we have announcers, announcers of, again, similar age. They can talk about shared memories, and often the announcer might get ready to play a song by Judy Garland, and they'll say, I remember going to see that that movie that she sang this song in, and I was only 10 years old or 12 or 15. And then they sort of trigger the sort of the conversation in the mind of the listener who thinks, oh yes, how old was I when I went? And then they start the conversation. So the whole concept of silver memories is about providing that companionship. So it has to be 24 hours a day. We know from research that we've done, the Federal Department of Health commissioned research about a year and a half, 2 years ago on silver memories.
Yes.
And they asked us to look at...
Yeah. Supported by the Australian Medical Association in Queensland, Alzheimer's Australia Queensland, and Dementia Behaviour Management Service as well. I mean, what fabulous endorsements.
Yes, it is. And we're so pleased that they have understood, you know, the power of music. Mirusia mentioned, you know, the impact that it has. And the science behind that is that the brain registers and retains memories of music on multiple sites of the brain. So even if a person's brain is dramatically affected by the ravages of dementia, there will usually still be one or two sites left that can still respond to those familiar tunes of their youth. And that's why I think it's magic. Science only knows of that happening with music, not with any of the other sort of aspects of reminiscence. So yeah. Music is unique in that regard.
Mm. It's almost music as medicine, isn't it?
Mm. Well, it's very interesting you say that. You know, the Hippocratic Oath of doctors, that they take the Hippocratic Oath, it's named after a Greek physician, Hippocrates. Yes. And Hippocrates used to prescribe doses of music to his patients. He would say, you're depressed, go off and play the harp for half an hour. Or you're feeling a bit tense, go and do some drumming for half an hour each day for a week and then come back and see me. He would prescribe music 2,500 years ago.
Put that back in the Hippocratic Oath.
Yeah.
Yes, they should do that nowadays.
They certainly should.
How about that?
Only 2,500 years too late.
Well, that's right, that's right. Now, Mirusia, you have kindly offered to give us some of your beautiful talent. And we would love for you to sing for us and give us a taste of what we can look forward to when we come out of lockdown and you start touring again.
Oh my gosh, I just can't wait to come all the way down the East Coast. Right now we're just starting in Queensland, but we will be making it down. And so, but in the meantime, here's a performance. Now, I chose a song that's a little bit uplifting. It's only 2.5 minutes, but I hope that those watching can sing along or dance along, because we've got a few different dance styles that come past in this wonderful arrangement. It's a Tommy Tico arrangement, wonderful arranger. He passed away not so long ago, wonderful man he was. And this beautiful arrangement is from My Fair Lady, and it's called I Could Have Danced All Night.
I feel so gorgeous.
I noticed Gary's flitting away. Bed, I couldn't go to bed. My head's too light to try to set it down. Sleep, sleep, I couldn't sleep tonight. Not for all the jewels in the crown. I could have danced all night, I could have danced all night, and still have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before. I'll never know what made it so exciting, when all at once my heart took flight. I only know when he
you know, you can see why just music does touch your soul, doesn't it?
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. That is wonderful. And thank you so much to both of you for bringing this platform to so many people. If people are interested in hooking in, Gary, how can we access this?
Yes, if people go to the website, silvermemories.com.au, and they'll have all the information about the service, the satellite service into aged care homes, but also about the app. And I'll just quickly sort of bring up the app so that people can get a bit of an idea of what they're looking for. So that's it on an iPad. And so they can actually
user friendly, Gary, actually.
Very, very, very simple. Hit that. You hear Silver Memories. Touch that button and you then get the images that come up and accompany the music as well. So you can go on a virtual tour of all sorts of places on a bit of a holiday, even though you're in
a
room.
So it's not just music. We're able to experience a tour, right?
And exactly.
Goodness. And did you say, Gary, there's also quizzes on there?
There are quizzes. There's a whole range of other activities that people can engage in. So if you touch on there, all sorts of quizzes about a whole range of topics. So it keeps the mind active well. And then there's the on-demand section, different music genres. So if you're a fan of the Andrews Sisters, a dozen or so songs you could enjoy there, all sorts of things. We have the ability to go into some of the programs that have been to air. If they missed them, they can have a listen again. So very, very straightforward and very simple. We even have on demand some church programs, for hymns, for those people that can no longer go to church. And a lot of people miss that if they can't. So we have some programs of favourite hymns.
So many people that was a core aspect to their week. And especially now that services, they can't have services in aged care facilities or villages with this whole pandemic. What a great way to access this and resume a bit of normality in their life.
Yes, we had feedback from some aged care homes that even though services couldn't be held, some of the residents were still getting into their best clothes.
Yes.
Because they've been doing that for all their life to go off to church.
Yeah.
And so we created this program called Our Favourite Hymns. We have a gentleman called Kevin. We call him Rev, Reverend Kev. And he's just wonderful. He's got a lovely sense of, again, providing that friendly companionship. And he takes them through some favourite hymns in a hymn program. And we repeat it on Sunday afternoon. So it's in the morning at 10 a.m. and then 2 p.m. in case they've had some activities in the morning and they'd miss it. So we really try to provide them with a service that suits their needs.
Look, I can't wait to have a look at it myself. We will put all of the links to this in our social so other people can make sure that they can get to it and also navigate their loved ones to access it as well, because it is a fabulous service that you have put together. So thank you so much. Thank you for your time this morning, Gary and Mirusia. Thank you as well. Thank you for being an ambassador to this entire project and giving us some beautiful, beautiful music. Stuff to look forward to for when you do start touring down the East Coast again.
Yes, and it's such an honour to be part of this. It really is providing so much happiness to so many.
It is. Well, thank you both and good morning to you, and we can't wait for more. We'll keep in touch.
Bye-bye for now.
Thank you, Martin. Bye-bye.
That was the lovely Gary and Mirusia of Silver Memories telling us all about their fabulous app. We can't wait for you to access that, and we'll put all of the details in our links. You've been with me, Martine, on Martini Mornings, only on moodfoodradio.com.